wanting to do a stand-up comedy show for a while. And what's crazy to me is that she put herself in such a vulnerable situation where she was just like, I'm just gonna rent out the theater and talk to everybody. And I was like, that is badass. So, I'm super pumped to bring you all the one, the only,
God damn, Jesus, move the fuck out of my way. Oh my God. Oh, Jesus. So, but Grandma's went to So we went to this New Year's party with all her public school friends, so I knew no one except my friends that I came there with, which, okay, so I'm very, like, outgoing and enthusiastic person, but when I'm in a room of people that I have no idea who the fuck you are, I'm like, I'm gonna not be a part of this party at all. So I just decided to get drunk, and, you know, I decided to, you know, get drunk on the world-renowned, most beautiful beverage that a 17-year-old can get their hands on. Mike's Hard Lemonade.
Out with one person every weekend. I don't care who you were. I didn't want to even like
go further with it. I didn't want to date you. I didn't want to sleep with you. I didn't want to do anything with you. I just wanted your mouth. And that was all you were good for. So that's how I did it. So every weekend, I would get super trash, and then I would make out with one. I'd be like at the party, like, dancing, like, who's it?
Sure.
Oh yeah. Yeah, she gonna do it. She ready. jungle juice. Oh. That was six people that night.
Hey.
Everybody was no one cute. 2 months. I was like, I'm going to really just be involved with, like, being on stage and being present in that moment. Great, good for you. And we were supposed to go to Europe in October. And I was like, oh my God, that's the perfect place for me to lose my virginity. I've never been to Europe before. Again, Jew, God, I killed two birds with one stone. First time in Europe, lose your virginity. Done. Finish her. We're supposed to go to Europe in October. She got sick, so we had to postpone Europe until January, February. Okay, great. We finished the rest of the tour out till Christmas. I go home for Christmas. It's like New Year's, and I'm sitting there making a New Year's wish, like, I need to lose my virginity in Europe. I don't need to do it. I am ready to fucking do it already. I'm just done. I'm ready. I'm ready to do it. New Year's wish. Oh my God. So we go to Europe, and the first place we go is Barcelona, and we're in Barcelona for about a week because we had, like, production rehearsals again. So it's like, oh my God, a week in Barcelona. Spanish, come on, Poppy, let's go. Barcelona, and if you've never been, it is, honest to God, the most beautiful hotel you will ever see in your whole entire life. You walk in the room, and the back of the bed is facing you, and the front of the bed is, like, facing, like, the window. And you lay in bed, hit the button, and the screen goes up, and it's spectacular view. It's, like, the city, the coast, the beach. Barcelona is as if, like, LA was nice and less traffic. You know what I'm saying? It's everything to offer you, but nice. And I love that about that place. But when I first saw the view, I just already was imagining, like, my hands. Someone behind me looking at the view, because I'm the view, and I can look at the view. So I have this fascination with London. Oh my my God, I have to lose my virginity in London. Like, this is the moment. This is the moment I was prepared for. Let's go. I was swiping right to pretty much everyone.
Friend in the
audience, don't you ever dare to hang out with each other and not invite me. If I see pictures, I'm going to kill you in your sleep. So I'm like, oh my God, I don't want to miss it. She's like, no, 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 you have to say yes. And I said yes, and I'm like, ah, shit. And he's like, okay, come over at 7. Oh, okay. So I returned back to the hotel, and I plucked every single hair that was in my body out of my body. Hair. Nothing. No wheatgrass anywhere. Clean out. But while I was like deplucking myself, I was like just really anxious, obviously. I mean, a lot of people here probably lost their virginity when they were teenagers and they kind of didn't really know like what was even going on in the first place. So being an adult and having a conscious mind is like, what the fuck? Oh my God. Every time I like second guess myself, I'm like, should I do it? Should I have done it? What am I doing? What am I doing? Oh my God. Being an adult is fucking terrible. God damn. So I'm talking myself down and I start listening to like girl power jams because like, you know, when you're down, you just gotta listen to pussy power jams. Like that just really gets my goat. So I'm really getting pumped up and then, you know, I head start to make my commute. Wow. And I take the tube because we're in London. I had my headphones in, and at this point, I'm kind of feeling myself because the only person that I could listen to who would encourage me and enlighten me to just get down to business is Rihanna. Rihanna is not afraid to have sex. She's the bad bitch, and I had to keep telling myself, I'm like, Rihanna's not afraid to have sex. She's not. You don't give a fuck. You're a bad bitch too. Oh hell yeah. And I probably was like bobbing back and forth. She was like, fuck yeah, bitch, yes. Woo! I like literally like want to be Rihanna. I'm wearing body lava. If you can't tell, I have a sparkly chest. I'm wearing Fenty Beauty bra. Fenty face. Guys, I'm Fenty made at her. I need to be sponsored soon. Thank you. So I'm getting the motions of it, and then I get off the tube, and we start WhatsApping each other. And then he was like, oh, are you American? I was like, oh, bitch, I'm definitely Latin. Because as much as I want to fuck English boys, they want to fuck American girls too. It's a win-win scenario. So I'm WhatsApping him. He's like, oh yeah, like I got this gin and a tin. I'm like, I have no idea what the fuck that means. But okay. He's like, if you want to stop off and get some alcohol. I said, okay, great. I'm going to pick up my best friend, Rosé, and I'm going to walk to your place. I tell him I'm here. I wasn't there yet, obviously. I got to make them wait for me. You know what I'm saying? And I walk up and I see him. And I'm like, holy shit. He's actually cute. Fuck. I was so nervous because, you know, I'm like, oh my dang, you don't fucking know. He might be like a toad. I don't know. Or a toe. I don't know. And I saw him and I was like, beautiful. And the first thing I saw, I was like, white boy with lips. It's a white boy with lips, bitch! Yes! We're talking about white boy with lips! Woo! I knew I was gonna be great. I was in good hands. Awesome. So, go to his place. Not the nicest place, but you know, Slumdog Millionaire. So I'm hanging out with him. We start talking about movies and TV shows, and like, you know, trying to get to know each other. And we talked about music, which is like my favorite thing to talk about. And then he was like, you know, I'm like super into right now. Like hell, because I'm trying to fuck him. Hell. I was like, Will Smith.
Okay, is shit really fucking behind over here? Like,
who was a career in the 90s? Are you okay? Like, are you from a time machine? Like, what's happening? He's like, no. I'm like, of course I know you was stuff, but like, I just like revisited the Wild Wild West. Bitchy women,
but I'm totally gonna fuck this guy.
But it was a moment to inspire. You know what I'm saying? Inspire, encourage, enlighten. Let's do it. Cisco, thong song, boom. And we were watching it. He was like, oh my, is this all it is? Like, just girls in, like, bikinis with their thongs? And I was like,
yeah, what else do you fucking need in the music
video? It's ass cheeks bumping around. And then, by this point, I drank a half a bottle of rosé. Oh, also, gin in a tin is like a pre-made gin tonic, which I didn't know, but Trader Joe's probably has, so check it out at your local Trader Joe's. So I'm drinking, I'm pretty drunk by this point, and then he's like, I'm gonna go to the bathroom. He's like, but why don't you put something on the Spotify playlist? I said, okay, great, girl, I got a lot of playlists, what you want? What kind of vibe are you feeling? And he was like, something sexy. I was like, oh my God, bitch, it's happening now, it's happening now, what am I gonna do? It's a fire emoji because with the fire we make. New single dropping on iTunes at midnight. Check it out. So I like get it all ready. I got my playlist going. It's great. He comes back in the room. You know, like we start making out. Whatever. One thing leads to another. I'm laying on his bed, and then he immediately just drops down on me. I'm like, oh. Hell yeah! Hell to the yeah! Because every other experience I had previously was always just like a man like pressing me down, like.
I'm a dirty girl. You just like chucks a towel at the girl's face and we're like, ah, fuck. Okay, so we're just kind of anticipating that that was what it was supposed to be like. So like, you know when it all ends and you're kind of like stuck in that position like, everyone just like throw me a towel and he gets up and I'm just anticipating like chug in my direction. He gets up. He gets baby wipes.
Yeah.
And then he wipes.
My call time was like 10. I didn't mean to wake up early. lies. It's okay. Didn't hurt him. And as he was leaving, he was like, he looked me in my eyes. He was like, "You're a special one." And all I could say back was, "Yeah, I know."
No one has fucked me previously because I say shit like that.
Yeah, I fucking heard it. So I said, I was like, I'm kidding. He laughed. He was like awkward and uncomfortable, but it's okay. He's like, whenever you're in London, I was like, you know I'm about to hit you up. Don't get it twisted. You know I'm about to be there. I'm about to be there, in there, swimwear. Ha. Ha. All right, let's cut to present day Caroline. This happened in January, the end of January. Present day Caroline, post virginity loss. So. Everyone told me that once I lost my virginity, I would be ravenous. I would just like want to have sex all the time. I'm like, no, I don't believe you. No, not me. Those motherfuckers are right as hell. I am fiending. I'm like, I'm always on the prowl. I'm sitting it out. I know that now that if I ever sniff someone, they probably would not want to fuck me. So I'm like, cool, let's speed skate on dicks.
$1 million, like $1 million bucks when I walk through. And while you got your tail tucked, boy, I caught you. And you can catch me in the cup.